Very good morning, students. Welcome back to the online class. In this class, what we are going to learn? It is English grammar. Okay, English grammar class. English grammar we are going to learn. Grammar, can you all remember where we have stopped? Just record your textbook. Nouns, lesson number 3, chapter number 3, nouns we have started. Can you all remember where we have stopped? I gave you some assignments also. It was less. Page number 21, the ninth main, the last assignment I gave you all, right? And that also I told you, I repeated the answers also, but I didn't wrote on the board. Till that, the collective noun we have stopped. Now, the next, what we are going to learn? First, take out all your grammar textbooks. Take out your grammar textbooks. It is page number 21. Should I write on the board? It is page number 21. Now we are starting. Take out page number 21. Take your pencil, eraser, and your textbook. Your grammar textbook, pencil, eraser. Take this and sit. Okay. Now, material noun. The material noun. What is material noun? It is a name given to a material from which something is made. Is no? A material from which something is made. This book, it is made by the papers. Yes, no, this book is made by the papers. Like that. Bag, it is made by the cloth. Right? Likewise, the material. Material noun means the name which is given for a particular material from which something is made from that. Understood? See, now the exercises will write. They have given some options: clay, cocoa, gold, silver, stone, sand, cloth, paper, plastic, milk. They have given this. These are the materials. Okay. From this, what they are preparing, they have given. They have just kept the blank for the materials what we have to fill. See, Kathy has a bag in her hand. Kathy has a bag in her hand. That bag is made of what? That bag is made of cloth, right? That is the 10th main. First one, it is the cloth. Now itself, right, students, when I'm telling itself, take your pencil and complete. Robin has made a castle on the beach. The castle is made of sand. Mother bought a tub. The tub is made of the tub from which it is made. It is made of plastic. Understood? These are the material nouns. These are the materials. I have a small flag. The flag is made of what? Paper. Look at the house. It is made of stone. Yes, the house is made of stone. This is my spoon. It is made of silver. This spoon is made of silver. Look at this beautiful necklace. It is made of what? Gold. Right? Next. 8th one. Mother has made chocolate. The chocolate is made of what? The chocolate is made of cocoa. Taste the sweet. The sweet is made of milk. Now you all are understanding, you all are getting how this material nouns. The potter is making pots. The pots are made of clay. Okay. Now read the passage below. Underline all the material nouns. Will you do this? See, the exercise I have solved. You have to underline the material nouns in this passage. I won't do this. You have to. See, do you know how to make chocolate at home? Mix sugar in some water and make a syrup. Add butter to it. Mix in milk powder, cocoa powder, and some essence. Mix well and allow to cool. Take small portions of chocolate and roll them into balls. Keep the balls in a fridge for some time. Your homemade chocolate is ready to heat. Here, what we can find as material noun from which the chocolate is prepared, that is the material nouns. See, which are those? Sugar, okay, sugar and syrup. For the syrup, sugar is used. And for that syrup, butter, butter, it is a material noun. Sugar, butter, milk powder, cocoa powder, these are all the material nouns. Understood? Sugar, butter, milk powder, cocoa powder, these are the material nouns you have to underline in this. Understood? I think you all have done this also by telling only when I'm telling the answers only. I hope you all have done. Right? Now, we'll learn about abstract noun. What is this? An abstract noun is the name of something we can think or feel but cannot see or touch. An abstract noun, it is the name of something which we can only think or feel but we can't touch it or see it. The abstract noun means the name of something what we can feel, right? What we can feel or we can think but we can't touch it, we can't feel it. Sorry, we can't see it. We'll just feel only that. It can name of a quality, kindness, honesty, courage, a state, death or life, a stage, childhood, an idea, beauty and feelings, happiness, sadness. These all comes under abstract nouns. Okay. See, now match the word with a suitable abstract noun. Match the word. We have to match the word with a suitable abstract noun. Now, what I'll do, I'll write the answers. Which are the proper answers I'll write. You have to write the numbers for that. Understood? See, sugar. Sugar, it is a sweetness. So, see where is the word sweetness and write there number one. Understood? Next, flower is a beauty. Flower is beauty. Milk, it gives strength. Soldier, courage. See where is this word courage and write number five. Book, knowledge. Parents, love. See, these are the abstract nouns. Can we all see this? Sweetness, beauty, strength. Can we all see this? No, we can feel it. Right? We can feel the sweetness. When you put a sugar into your mouth, you can feel the sweetness. Can you see the sweetness? No, you can feel it. Yes, no, the beauty, you can feel it, strength, you can feel, you can think. That's it, we can't see all this, we can't touch knowledge. Can we touch the knowledge? No, we can see, we can think the knowledge, we can feel, right? We'll get the knowledge, but we can't touch the knowledge. That is an abstract noun. See, choose an abstract noun to fill in the blanks. We have to choose the abstract noun from where they have given the options down here. See, which are those? Hunger, happiness, faith, kindness, honesty, intelligence, confidence, truth, wisdom, life. Okay, these are the abstract nouns they have given. We have to choose the correct one to fill the blanks. Okay. Now it is the 13th main. Okay. 13th main, a wise man is said to have wisdom. A wise man is said to have wisdom. Write down now itself, write with me. Being confident is to have confidence. Being confident is to have confidence. He never tells a lie, he always speaks the truth. T-R-U-T-H, truth. All living things have life. Have faith in God. शो काइंडनेस टू एनिमल्स, शो काइंडनेस टू एनिमल्स. सॉरी, एन हॉनेस्ट मैन शोज हॉनेस्टी, एन हॉनेस्ट मैन शोज हॉनेस्टी इन एवरीथिंग ही डज. डॉग्स हैव अ लॉट ऑफ इंटेलिजेंस. A healthy man enjoys happiness. Many people in India die of hunger every year. See, these are the answers. Once again, I'll repeat. First one, a wise man is said to have wisdom. Being confident is to have confidence. He never tells a lie. He always speaks the truth. All living things have life. Have faith in God. Show kindness to animals. An honest man shows honesty in everything he does. Dogs have a lot of intelligence. A healthy man enjoys happiness. Many people in India die of hunger every year. Okay, these were the answers. And next is the match the verb with the abstract noun it makes. Here we have to match the words. It is fourth May. Try it yourself. I'll just tell it. Try it yourself. Match the verbs with the abstract noun it makes. See, speak. Speak is speech. Okay, speak, it is a speech, S-P-E-E-C-H. In the answer side, it is third one. There, go and write number one. Number one. Sell, 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 sell. Okay, third one, act, action. You all are now getting, no? Die, death. Grow, growth. Invite, invitation. Okay. See, now match the following answers. I'll tell 4, 5, 1, 3, 6, 2. First one is speak, speech, sell, sale, act, action, die, death, grow, growth, invite, invitation. Okay. Next is read the passage and underline the abstract nouns. Here in this passage, we have to underline the abstract nouns. See the passage. What is the passage? The whole world knows about the greatness of Mother Teresa. From her childhood, Mother Teresa had a lot of faith in God. When she was 18, she heard the voice of God, which told her to do service to mankind. From that day, she spent all her life serving the poor and needy. Even today, she stands as a symbol of love and kindness. She is known as beacon in the world of darkness. Okay, here in this passage, they have given about Mother Teresa, about her kindness. They have given. In that, we have to underline the abstract nouns. Okay, see, I'll write which are the abstract nouns. The whole world knows about the greatness. Greatness of Mother Teresa from her childhood. Mother Teresa had a lot of faith in God. When she was 18, she heard the voice of God, which told her to do service to mankind. From that day, she spent all her life serving the poor and needy. Even today, she stands as a symbol of love and kindness. And she is known as the beacon in the world of darkness. Okay? These are the abstract nouns which you have to underline. Now, the next topic is countable and uncountable nouns. Countable and uncountable nouns. Here, what is this countable and uncountable? See, the nouns which we can count, the nouns which we can count are called as countable. The nouns which we cannot count, it is called as uncountable. See now, countable. See, you can count this books, right? You can count how many books are there. You can count the chalk, how many chalks are there, right? You can count. But if it comes to papers, if it is more, if it is very less, means we can count. Okay, not a problem. If it comes to more papers, can we count it? No, it is uncountable. Stars. Can we count the stars? No, we can't count. Right? Sun, moon, it is only one. We can count. But stars, can we count? No. The water, can you count the water? No. Sugar, can you count? No. Rice, can you count? No. But eggs, you can count. Right? Bread, chocolate, you can count. Butter, can you count? No. Like that, the things, the nouns which we can count, it is called as countable nouns. The nouns which we cannot count, it is called as uncountable nouns. See now, countable nouns. Countable means we can count. See here, bag we can count. Apple, we can count. Eggs, we can count. Caps, we can count. Oranges, we can. Many stars, no, we can't count. Three pens, yes, three pens means we can count, right? How uncountable nouns. See, how much uncountable means a lot of paint. Paint, can we count? No. Water, can we count? No. Salt, if it is very less also, can we count? No. Oil, no, we can't count. Sugar, no. Butter, no. These all comes under uncountable nouns, which we can't count. Okay. A noun used in answer to the question, how many is a countable noun? How many? And the common nouns and the collective nouns are countables. Common nouns and collective nouns. Common nouns and collective nouns are countable nouns. And in the question, if it comes how many, it is countable. Okay. And in the question, if it comes how much, it is uncountable. And the material nouns and abstract nouns are the uncountable nouns. Understood? Countable means the nouns which we can count. Uncountable, which we cannot count. In that countable, we can see the words how many are there. How many means we can count, right? How much is there means we can't count, right? How much rice is there? Rice, we can't tell how many rice is there. We'll tell how many rice is there? No. We tell how much rice, how much water, how much oil. Can we tell how many oil? No. See, this is the difference. And here, common nouns and collective nouns. These are countable. This we can count, common nouns and as well as collective nouns. But the material nouns and abstract nouns, we can't count. Understood? Okay, now, you have to write C or U in the box. So C is countable, U is uncountable. Countable or uncountable, you have to write. They have given some pictures for that. You have to write which is countable, which is uncountable. Okay. Now see, stars, they are given very less stars. You can count, right? See. Next is a cup of tea or coffee. Can you count that? No, it is not plain. Something is there inside. Tea or coffee, something is there. Can we count that? No, it is uncountable, right? You. Next is water. Can we count? No, right? You. Next is sand. Can we count? No, you. A book. Book, we can count. Next, C. Next is C. Biscuits, they have given. We can count. Milk, can we count? No, it is uncountable. You. Three children, we can count. See, sugar, can we count? No, you. Cats, there are only two, we can count. It is three. Okay, now, see now, countable nouns have, I hope you all have completed, right? See, once again, I'll tell. See, first one, see, you, see. In first line, first one, last one, see, countable. Middle three it is uncountable. And next again, countable, uncountable, countable, uncountable, countable. Okay? Next, countable nouns have both singular and plural forms. Countable nouns, it have both singular as well as plural forms. It has both the singular and plural forms. The articles a and an are used with singular countable nouns. The quantifiers of few, many, lots of, and some are used with the plural countable nouns. Okay? Uncountable nouns do not have both singular and plural forms. Most of them are singular while some are plural. We do not use the articles a and an with uncountable nouns. We do not use a and an with the plural, a and with uncountable nouns. Okay. The quantifiers are little, much, some, lot of. Go with uncountable nouns. Okay. For the plural countable nouns, what we use? Countable nouns, a few, many, lots of, some. Okay. Uncountable nouns, what we use? A little, much, some, a lot of. Understood? Now, fill in the blanks with the given words. I have given some options we have to fill. So it is page number 26. This page number 26. Second move. Okay. In this, there are many people in the bus stop. We can count many. There are many people in the bus stop. I have many friends. He ate an egg and a bread. There are only few fish in pond. There is only little milk in the jug. Little. Have you got any money? Any. There are many boys in the classroom. They have got a car. Add a little, add. A little salt to the salad. Would you like a little coffee? Would you like a coffee? Would you like a coffee? There aren't any seats in hall. It is full. Any. There isn't any sugar in tin. Any. Okay. See now next. We use how much with uncountable nouns. We use how many with countable nouns. Here, we have to again fill in the blanks with how much and how many. How much and how many. See, first one, dash books are there in the library. How many? We use how many. How many books are there in library? Next is how much rice do we need every month? It is how much. You are getting now, right? You all are understanding. Next is How many apples? How many apples are there in the fridge? Next is fourth one. How much petrol? See, which is not countable. It is, we have to use how much. Which is countable, we have to use how many. Countable, how many? Uncountable, how much? The next, how many children are here? How many? How much floor do you have? How much? How many cups are broken? How many shirts did you buy? Again, how many? We can count the shirts. Next is, how much money did you spend? How much? How much water is there in the tank? Okay, this is how you have to fill. See, once again, I'll repeat. How many? How much? How many? How much? How many? I'll just repeat with the questions. See, how many books are there in the library? How much rice do we need every month? How many apples are there in the fridge? How much petrol does the car use? How many children are here? How much floor do you need? How many cups are broken? How many shirts did you buy? How much money did you spend? How much water is there in the tank? Okay. And next main is write correct for the correct sentence and wrong for the wrong sentence. We have to see which is the correct and which is the wrong in the sentence what they have given. You all are writing, your students. You all are copying. Now only if you are writing slowly, just pause it and complete it and start. Okay? Don't leave blank. Don't keep it incomplete. Now, fourth main. I have a few marbles in my pocket. I have a few marbles. Yes, marbles. We can count. Right. He added many sugars. Many. Can we use many sugars? No, he added little or more sugar. We have to tell sugar. We can't count. It is wrong. Many sugars. It is wrong. There is not much juice left in jug. Yes, it's right. Fourth one, the child has many toys. Yes, right. He plucked a mango from the tree. Right. I ate two breads. Yes. There isn't any salt in the curry. Next to seventh one, right. The sentence is proper only. There is a few water in the river. Right. Sorry, there is a little water. So it is wrong. We have to tell there is a little water in the river. It is wrong. We play many games. Right. They have a lot of money. Right. Okay. See, your second one and eighth one are wrong sentences and remaining all are correct sentences. And I'll stop my class here. In the next class, we'll learn about the plurals. Okay. We learn about plurals. And after that, the possessive forms of nouns. These two topics, plurals and the possessive nouns, if we complete this noun part, it is completed. Okay. And in this grammar class today, you got only one homework. I think that also you have completed. No homework today. And practice this grammar. And once you go through the points which are given, okay. Understood? I'll stop my class here. Next class we'll be doing another two topics. By that, your nouns chapter will be completed. Okay? Thank you, students.